Well, hello and welcome to this episode of The Terri Cole Show. This is episode 262, if you can believe that. If you're new to this crew, my name is Terri Cole and I'm a licensed psychotherapist, a relationship expert, and the founder of Real Love Revolution and Boundary Bootcamp. And I'm also the proud author of a book called Boundary Boss, coming out in April of 2021. On today's episode, I'm going to be talking about the difference between true love and trauma bonding. So trauma bonding has become sort of popularized. I've been seeing it on the internet. I've had people email me questions about how can I tell the difference, if it's like the real thing or if it's just trauma bonding. But I think a lot of people don't actually understand what trauma bonding is, what it really is. So let's start from the beginning of what trauma bonding is, and then we can move into how you can tell the difference between trauma bonding and a healthy relationship. So have you ever been in a relationship that starts fast and furious? That the person thinks you're perfect? That you are swept off your feet like you've never been before in your life? It's real love, it's true love, but everything is happening very quickly. A lot of times that is the beginning of an unhealthy relationship, right? Because healthy love, even if you have a real attraction, it develops over time as you slowly but surely get to know the other person. With unhealthy relationships, there is a tendency, it can be, that you are, it's just fast and furious, like you're bonded immediately, or the other person is, or you may be, love bombing, where there is so much coming from the other person about how amazing and special and unique and awesome you are. And there really is a very, usually with unhealthy or trauma bonding relationships, there can be a very hot chemistry. And a lot of times, lust and love can feel a lot alike, especially in the beginning, because you have all these endorphins being released in your brain. It just feels like, what could be wrong? This is amazing, the most special thing I've ever had in my life. So let's go back to, what is trauma bonding? So this was coined by Patrick Carnes, and it basically, he used it to describe how the misuse of fear, excitement, and sexual feelings can be used to trap or entangle someone. So let's do that again. The misuse of fear, excitement, and sexual feelings. So imagine that they all go like this. Now, think about childhood, right? If you are had an abusive background in your childhood, grew up in a chaotic home, this pattern of trauma bonding, which is the ups and downs of, in the beginning of a trauma bonding relationship, or any really unhealthy relationship, it may be amazing and beautiful until it's not. In healthy relationships, it goes like this. You meet, there's an attraction, you're excited, you fall in love. Over time, it develops into something. And then over long periods of time, you know, the passion moves into a different kind of love. Not that you can't still be passionate, of course you can, but it develops into a deeper, more intimate knowing of the other person, a more abiding friendship with passion still there. But with a trauma bonding relationship, it starts fast and furious, extremely passionate, but then it moves into something that's more explosive, that's incredibly painful, that it's amazing, it's terrible. So you have these major ups and downs. And if you grew up in a home with this type of behavior, abusive behavior, basically, you can be very vulnerable to repeating that pattern in your adult relationships. Hence, you become very vulnerable to ending up in a relationship where you are trauma bonded. So imagine it this way. If in your young life, love and pain, right, went like that, you can see how this would entangle you or make it confusing to be able to recognize healthy love. Because a lot of my clients who've had this experience, when they start getting healthier and getting into healthier bonded relationships, it feels a little flat, right? Because you don't have the excitement, the drama, the high highs and the low lows nearly as much as you do, or at all. When you're in a trauma bonded relationship, it's very much up and down. So I created a little cheat sheet for you. All you need to do to get it is go to terricole.com/262 and you will get the download. So there's some questions you can answer. I'll give you some step-by-step stuff. So moving back to, now we understand more of what trauma bonding is. It's a cycle of being devalued and then rewarded over and over. So this becomes the norm. This becomes what you're looking for. And there are chemical and hormonal things that happen in this process that really get you so stuck in this relationship. So I'm going to talk a little bit about how you can tell if you're in a relationship and you are trauma bonded, right? How can you tell? Well, part of it is, you know you should leave the relationship and you simply cannot get yourself to do it. You say you're going to, you make a plan, but you don't, because there is this unconscious material and this draw. I sometimes describe it as like the cracked pot finds like the perfectly cracked lid to fit. That's what this is like. So if you've many times said you're going to, but you don't, that is an indication. If you wouldn't want one of your children to be in a relationship like you're in, if you wouldn't want someone you love to be having the experience you're having in your relationship, that tells you something about how you actually feel about your relationship. And another thing is, if the person is familiar to you in some way, so much of the time we repeat, right? There's that famous quote, we repeat what we do not repair. And that's what happens here too. So if you're in a relationship and you ask yourself what I call this little tool that I created called the three Q's, who does this person remind me of? Where have I felt like this before? And why is this relationship, or how is this behavioral dynamic itself familiar to me? You might be able to say, oh my God, it's just like my parents' relationship, or I experienced something very similar in childhood or in other friendships, because it doesn't only have to be romantic relationships. We can be trauma bonded to others, but it's most commonly in romantic relationships. And another thing that happens in any kind of abusive relationships, and that includes trauma bonded relationships, of course, because that's really the main thrust of a trauma-bonded relationship, is that you're always trying to get back to an earlier phase of the relationship when it was better, like the beginning. So the love-bombing phase, where everything is perfect and they're showering you with gifts and praise and verbal affection and physical affection, it seems like once you sort of hit the tipping point where you go into the next phase of the cycle, you're always like working to get back to that. And if you don't want your friends and family to know what's going on in your relationship, right? You're making excuses for the person, even though you know that what they're doing is not cool and what you're doing is not cool because you're staying in it. Moving into, so what can you do? Well, you can use the three Q's. That would be helpful. And I'll call that sort of do an inventory of like, how is it familiar? Get educated, right? Get online, get educated, learn everything you can about trauma bonding, not just the pop culture of it all. Really read from people who actually know, psychotherapists, clinicians, psychologists, go to Psychology Today and learn about how you fit into it and what the dynamic is like. But that you can do that, and that is free. You can also get help, right? Get into therapy. I've got an association with betterhelp.com, which is a virtual therapy service that you can use. I'm actually an affiliate for them. But I've vetted their services with my team, and they're amazing. But if you really want to be with someone who has trauma experience, a therapist who is a trauma expert is what you would actually need. And the last thing I can say about this is think about getting out of the relationship. Make a plan to safely get out and go no contact. If you're in an actively abusive relationship right now, I mean, your safety is the most important. I did a whole other video on this, which I will drop the link in the little guide for you, terricole.com/262. Because love, real love, doesn't feel like that. Healthy love does not feel like that, where the person who you love so much hurts you so much. In healthy love, there's a space for you to grow within the relationship. You're not dealing with that, and you don't deserve that, but you've got to heal your own trauma stuff if you want to stop being attracted to these types of abusive relationships. So I just wanted to clarify those things. I hope this was helpful. I hope you download the guide that I made for you. If you liked this video, please share it. Drop me a comment. Let me know your thoughts. You know, I love to interact with you guys. I hope that you have an amazing week. And as always, take care of you.